Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video series I will teach you how to create awesome ARKit games with the help, of course, of SceneKit. Now, in this video I will create an ARKit game from a single view application. So without further ado, let's get started. First of all, let's open up our Finder here and let's create a new folder on our desktop, and I will call this AR Magic because I will name my project AR Magic. Here it is. Okay, good stuff. Now let's open up Xcode and let's create, let me just take this down, and let's create a new project. Okay. And you could create an augmented reality app template, but now we are going to create a single view application because why not? Because we will learn the basics of an ARKit game. So do not choose augmented reality app, choose a single view app, and then let's just click on next. Now the product name should be AR Magic. Okay. And let it be our language Swift, and finally let's click on next, and I will create a Git repository because I will store this on GitHub. You may go there and check out this repository for yourself on my GitHub profile. So let's choose AR Magic for the folder that I want to store this, and let's click on create. Good stuff. Now, before we move forward, let us commit this to our GitHub repository. So I will just choose this little icon, show the source control navigator, and I will just unfold these, and as you can see there are no remotes. So I will just right click on it and let's create AR Magic remote on GitHub. Okay, and this time it will be a public. And as you can see, the repository name should remain AR Magic, and it will be at https://github.com/rebeloper/ARMagic. So go ahead and take a look at the existing project. Maybe it is finished, maybe it is not. It depends on whether the time of and day of you watching this video in the future. So I just create it as public. And let's create this. Let's wait for it. It is pushing it up and great, it is live. Now I want to create a new branch from the master. Well, first of all, let us just commit this. Okay, let's commit. Let's see if nothing to commit because it has already pushed it up and committed. It has first committed and then pushed it up to the GitHub repository. So let us just right click on the master branch and let's create a branch from master, and I will name this. So it is quite descriptive. I will try to follow this descriptive branch name. So you may go to your GitHub repository and find the one lesson you want. So let's create this, and as you can see we are in the current branch ARKit from single view application. Okay, now let's go back and finally let's get started on the code. So what do we want to achieve? First of all, let's take a look at how this single view application is created. Well, we have our main storyboard and it is called the main interface is set to main, so the main storyboard will load. Well, as you might have already known, I really do not like using storyboards or SKS files for the matter of fact, and I will now show you how you can avoid using storyboards and do all of this in code. So I would just simply delete the main interface, what is just I did, and I will just delete the main.storyboard file too. Let's move it to trash. So now we don't have a main storyboard. Okay, Now let's get to coding. Go ahead and open up your appdelegate.swift file, and inside here, as you can see, we already have a UI window variable declared. Now we have to instantiate it. So window equals to UI window. Okay, and now we need to make it key and visible. So go ahead and type in window, make key and visible. Good stuff till now. Now all we need to do is create a view controller instance of it, of a view controller, and add that view controller to the root of our window. This root view controller will have some kind of a UI view controller, and I will just create this now here. Game view controller, and that will be equal to game view controller. And for this to actually happen, we need to create a game view controller file here, a class, and I will put it, of course, in a new file. And let it be a Swift file. Let's click on next. And I would just name this game view controller with a double L here. And let's create this. Okay, I will just simply import ARKit for now. And let's create our class here. Of course, the name is the game view controller, and it is of a superclass UI view controller. And let's add our did load. Okay, and maybe add our super view did load. Okay, now we have our game view controller set up, and let's go back to our appdelegate, and as you can see, we have our game view controller constant ready. So we just simply add here game view controller, and everything should compile correctly. Maybe hit a command B to build it out. Now, next thing, maybe let us just delete our default view controller. Let's move it to trash. Okay, now we need to create manually an AR scene view, ARKit view. So I will just create it here. So let AR view, and it will be of ARSCNView. AR is for ARKit, SCN is for SceneKit, because ARKit it uses SceneKit. So it uses a lot of 3D objects, of course, and scene SCN objects, like SceneKit's objects. Okay, and that is why this abbreviation ARSCN is used for, well, most of the ARKit elements. So I will just type in here view, and that will be an ARSCNView. Oh, sorry about that. We need to put in here a let, and now we should get the completion, and it will be a simple ARSCNView. We are not giving it a frame because we are going to add some anchors later on in the didMoveToView function. Okay, and let's return our view now. Okay, now we have an AR view. What we need to do is simply, the error just disappeared. Okay, thank you, Xcode compiler. Okay, now we need to select our view, and let's add a subview, our AR view, as a subview to our view. But now we need to still position our view, and that will be done through our constraints. So AR view dot, let's start with the top anchor, and let's constrain it. Constrain, and I will select this equal to because I want to constrain it to our views top anchor. So we are constraining it to the views top anchor, so it will go all the way up to our top anchor, and of course we need to activate it. So is active equals true. Okay, the same goes for all the other three anchors. So I will just simply copy this, paste it three more times, and change this to right anchor. And here it is. We have set up our top, right, bottom, and left anchors. And now this AR view should constrain to the frame of our app. Now, this is all you have to do to add an ARSCNView. Now we need to actually create our ARKit views. Well, we need to add a configuration, an ARKit word tracking configuration. So, and that will be of ARSCN. Here it is, AR word tracking configuration. Okay, and now we need to add this configuration to our AR view. So AR view dot session dot run, and here it is, run configuration, and I will get add in a simple configuration here, and the options will be, well, no options. If you want to add it here, you can check out what kind of options there are. Well, there are run options, remove existing anchors, reset tracking. We will talk about this maybe in a later video when we maybe want to reset the existing anchors and reset the tracking. For now, we will just leave this array as empty. And finally, we are going to add some debug options because, well, this really works, but you can't really see anything. Of course, you can see through the camera on your device, but nothing really happens. So we are going to get some debug options. So AR view dot, and here we have our debug options, and that will be equal to, and we will add two debug options. So I will just create an array here, ARSCN debug options. There you have it. And let's add a dot here. And as you can see, we have two, show feature points and show word origins. Well, let's add both of them here, and I will just go through each and every each one of them in just a second. So, show feature points. This is how your app receives the data from the word that is shown through the camera. These will be little yellow dots on your screen. And show word origin, that will show the origin of the word that the game has created upon first launch. You will see origin red, blue, and green immediately. Now, one last thing that you need to add in order to build and run this project is go to your info plist file under your target, and here let us just click on this little plus button and type in with a capital P privacy, and you will need camera usage description, because, and I will just tell you, because this is needed for the Apple project. Well, this is needed for Apple to show the user that you need camera usage. So it will prompt the user to agree to use their cameras. This is a new requirement from Apple. If a user declines this usage, well, it can't be used with this app. Okay, and I will type in here. So privacy camera usage description, why do we want to use And that is a pretty good explanation why we need our camera. Okay, and finally, you will need to have a real device plugged in for testing. That is because ARKit games cannot be used in the simulator because they are using the camera, of course, and the environment that you want to test your app in. So you will need a real device for testing this. So I have set up here my QuickTime player, and it is showing my device, and I will just simply select my device and build and run, and let's see what happens. Okay, build has succeeded, and there it is, AR magic. Let's just wait for it. We are inside, and as you can see, AR magic would like to access the camera, and the reason is show AR world. Let's allow this. Okay, I believe I have omitted one final very crucial step, and that is, let me just double check, I believe yes, and this is why I'm going to create a new tutorial on this. It's about adding these constraints. I will make it much easier, but for now what you need to remember is for the views, translate auto resizing mask into constraints equal to false. Okay, and now let's test again. So let's build and run, and let me show you my device. Well, I need to unlock it first. Okay, and there you have it. Okay, and let it just familiarize itself. As you can see, there are these yellow dots, and if I just back up a little bit, you will see the origin. This is put at the very beginning of our launch, where the device was, so it was like here. Okay, and that is the origin. The yellow dots are those feature points that we will use later on, and we will use this origin too. Okay, hope you enjoyed this video. We will add a new button here, right here, to add new elements into the scene in the next video, and I will cover all of these constraints in the next video when we will add this add button. Hope you enjoyed this video, and if you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends, of course, and if you haven't already done so, go ahead and subscribe to this channel to see more videos of, and this playlist is about, ARKit and SceneKit development. Okay, I will see you in the next one.